وَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا.
God. The Holy Spirit is fully God. The spiritual part of Jesus Christ is fully God. Then he surely got three fully gods.
Three fully. It doesn't. You know why you don't have three fully gods?
That's what you said.
No. Because it is spirit. You're not quantified. That's the point.
It's God's spirit. How many gods are there? You just quantified it.
Okay.
But you said it's not quantifiable.
Okay.
Now you're saying it's only one.
Quantify means you say 1, 2 percentage, 14 percentage. That's what quantify means.
Percentage means one. 100% means one. That one pie.
I give you an example. All of them. Remember thing which is infinite.
No, there was nothing. I didn't have any.
If it's only one, yes, it's one infinite being. I.e. God.
If you add infinite to infinite.
No, but
there's no such thing. When you say infinite to infinite, you know infinite is a concept, it's not a number. Infinite is not quantifiable in that sense. But when you're talking about a numeric one, yes, I can say one infinite God. And I have no issue with that. And I believe you do not have any issue with that.
The reason why you are mistaken.
Which part am I mistaken about? About the infinite.
Because when you add things, by default, you use physical stuff.
Not necessarily.
No.
I give you an example of God, who's not physical. But he's one.
When we start adding things, let's say addition, you say, okay, this is one stick, another stick. Brother, three sticks. So you are adding things in the physical world. Exactly. So that's why when you are talking about something which is not in the physical world, doesn't make sense.
Let me ask
that,
you.
That's what I'm.
No. I'll tell you where you. I'll tell you where you're wrong. How many angels are there?
How many angels?
Yes.
How can I know how many angels?
But there are angels, right? And they are spirit. Yes. And when we say that an angel came to, say for example, Mary, we can say one angel came to Mary.
One angel came to Mary.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. How many gods were walking with Adam and Eve in paradise? Again, a spiritual being.
I tell you why the example of one. You say one angel came to
Mary.
Here on earth. One angel came to Mary.
Just an example. Maybe more than one came, but one angel.
Exactly.
Came
so to once you start talking about things that are on earth. Become physical, you can quantify. When you start talking about things that are
in heaven,
not on this earth, in the physical realm, you cannot quantify. It becomes difficult to quantify.
But why did you say there was one God?
You did say there is one God.
God. Why did you say you quantify? You just said there is one God. You didn't say it was a complicated one God. You just
I said that. When we went over there.
But just now you said there was one God.
Okay, but yeah, there's one God. Okay.
You're saying spirit cannot be quantified, but yet you say God is one.
Exactly.
You're somehow contradicting yourself.
No.
Without realizing.
Because the one, it can be something that you count, or it can be something that is unique. So when you say one, that
regardless, it's still quantifiable.
So,
it's still quantifiable, my friend. Whether you call it unique or one, it's still something you've already quantified it as being one.
Unique God. Okay, I ask you the same question. Is God one?
Yes. You see, I didn't make it complicated,
okay,
did I?
Your God is one.
Yes.
It's not two.
No, it's not two.
Exactly. So when you start saying two, you're adding numbers, it's quantifying. Exactly. So
what is the point?
I'm just telling you, one is just, it's not only a number. You can say unique. So when we
one
say
is one a number, God, by the way. I don't know which math says one is not a number.
It's not only, when I say, it's not only a number. When it's a number.
But it is a number, is it not?
Let's say God. When you say God is one, it's a number.
Yes.
And one can be
a group of people. One like a group of people.
Exactly.
Yeah. So God is a team of
unity.
So you're saying God is a group of people.
I'm just trying to
tell
you. I'm just
the unity.
This gets it worse.
I'm just trying to tell you that when I say God is one, it's not. I'm not trying to quantify something. I'm just saying.
But my friend, look. We don't need to argue on this. We both believe God is one.
Exactly. So we are turning.
No, we are not going in circles. When you say that God, the Father, is 100% God, fully God, which you agree to. The Son is fully God. The Holy Spirit is fully God. How many fully gods have you got?
I'm saying this is...
You got three fully gods.
When you are out of...
And that's polytheism.
When you are out of the material realm, okay, this addition you're doing doesn't make sense.
It does make sense.
That's what I'm telling you.
Actually, you're the one who...
It makes sense here. I can count things here.
My friend, you know what? When you use the word Trinity... Wait. You're already quantifying it as three. When you use the word Trinity...
I never use Trinity. Sorry. You brought the word Trinity.
What word would you use instead of the Trinity? What word would you use?
I told you that God is expressing himself...
As what? Expressing himself as what?
He's expressing himself.
As what?
What do you mean?
It probably means you're saying that God... You believe in modalism, where God expresses himself in different ways.
Yes, modalism.
So God can be.
So he's basically calling you a heresy of modalism. You know that's a heresy.
I'm just saying it's not.
I'm just making it clear to him what you're implying. Because when you say you believe in modalism, it's a heresy.
I don't care about what you're saying. Christians have different beliefs. Even right now, you are Muslim, you have a belief, someone else has a belief. People have different beliefs. Okay? So, I'm not trying to defend theology and whatever. I'm just telling you from the beginning the way I understand. And some people can say, what you say is not true. You are an heretic, right?
But he was implying that you believe in modalism, and modalism is a heresy.
According to who?
According to Christians. Like him.
Early church fathers, yeah.
Anyway, that's a different topic. Let's not go there.
For me, you know what?
You know, you said you didn't use the word Trinity. And to me,
I'm not here to defend Trinity.
I'm saying that, look, whether you use the word Trinity or not, you believe in the Trinity.
Really?
Okay. The reason we're using the word Trinity is because that is a concept that you define as God manifesting as a Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
No, I'm just reading what the Bible is saying, and that's how I understand.
No, but what you're reading, what you're saying is not reading from the Bible. What you're saying is based on your opinions.
For example, when you said
the Father is fully God, the Son is fully God, and the Holy Spirit is fully God. Nowhere in the Bible does it say the Son is fully God.
You asked the question, I just answered you.
Or the Holy Spirit. It might say in certain verses. But we are talking about God as one. You see, one entity, God. And you're somehow saying that the Father is that one entity. And that's it, fully God.
And the Son is then another entity who's also fully God. I just explained.
How you explain, my friend.
Do you get my explanation of God and the Word? The Spirit and the Father. This is what I see as
God. My friend, that's good.
This is what I see from the Bible.
You see, when you say from the Bible, so far you have not given me a single verse where it says these three are one.
I gave you two, but it's like you're asking the same question,
Hold on. You gave me John 1:1, and you gave me the beginning of Genesis.
You ask the question again, I give the answer.
You thought you gave the answer, but where in those two verses?
I never give an answer.
No, hold on.
Come on.
You're saying that you gave me these two verses, beginning of John 1, and the beginning of Genesis 1. You thought you gave me the answer based on that. In neither of these two verses, let's be fair. Either of these two verses explicitly state that the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit are one. Does it say that? Because in one you don't have the Son, and in the other one you don't have the Holy Spirit.
Because probably I don't know what you really want me to say.
It's very simple. My question once again, from the Bible, are you able to establish that the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit are one being?
Okay, are one
so far
being.
I've seen the differences.
Okay,
I haven't seen the other one.
But
how are they one?
We're coming back again.
No, we are not coming back to the question, which is unanswered.
That the God, Yahweh, is Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
And I asked you, is the Father, Yahweh?
Because when I read the Bible, this is how he expresses himself.
There's a difference.
So show me what he's saying.
What he's saying is that show that these three are one. But what you're doing, you're just mentioning them. There's no verse that says that they are one. We agree that it does mention all three of them. It mentions the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. But there's no verse that says they are one. Just because he mentions them doesn't mean they're one.
You know, actually, okay, there was one. Yeah, okay. Remember, we talked earlier about the King James Version?
Okay, now
there was actually a verse which says
they
if they are one.
They understand that now.
In the King James Version. Yes, but that has been found to be. Yeah, I know you don't believe that, but that is the only specific verse you had in the Bible, which we know is not true.
So to clarify, when I tell you that the Father manifests himself in having the Son, the Spirit, and the Word, for you, it doesn't mean that they are one.
Okay, show me where.
No, just tell me.
No. For you to say something is your opinion. Should be backed up by the Bible.
You're asking me my opinion or not?
No, I'm asking you back it up with the Bible.
But before
you're entitled to your opinion.
But
you have to back it up from the Bible. That's all I'm saying.
Answer, I just want to know where you're coming from. When I say the Father is manifesting himself to the Son,
with God.
The God is manifesting.
Manifest as Father.
As Father, Son, or Spirit. I want to know, according to you, doesn't mean that these three are one.
Okay, I'll tell you why.
No,
I don't believe that.
Okay.
And I don't believe.
No, I know where you come from. Okay.
Because I want to show you how the Bible actually goes against what you just claimed.
Okay.
When you say God manifests himself as a spirit, yes, the spirit, should it be God then after he's manifesting as a spirit?
Jesus.
Hold on. Should the spirit be God? When God manifests himself as the Holy Spirit, should the spirit be God?
When he manifests himself, because you cannot, you manifest yourself to, okay, I come back to the example I gave in the beginning. Right now, you manifest yourself.
No, without analogies.
No.
Let's not use analogies.
Okay, so
because you didn't like my pie analogy, and somehow I don't like your body, spirit, and soul analogy. So just answer the question.
To be honest, it's a simple question.
When God manifests himself as the Holy Spirit, is the Holy Spirit God?
Simple question.
Very simple. There's no need for analogies here.
When God manifests himself through the Holy Spirit, if the Holy Spirit is God,
yes,
the same as you are a human being, simple as that. Your body,
don't use analogies.
Yourself,
do not, without body. Using analogies,
because now we cannot talk.
You quantify.
Why not?
Yeah.
Are you saying that you are unable to answer without analogy?
The reason
now?
Why I explain why I didn't accept your analogy.
Which analogy?
The pie, because the pie is physical stuff.
Well, so is the body. The body is physical.
But your soul is not.
Yeah, but you're not. You're only using the soul, are you?
Your spirit is not physical.
My friend,
I'm just your body.
Hold on. In your analogy, you're not using only spiritual examples. You're also using the body, which is very much physical. So how is it you can have your way, I can't have my way?
Because your way.
I should have my pie too.
No. Because your pie.
I'm making you hungry. Am I now?
Good to share. Good to share.
Good pie.
That's a good pie.
Wrong analogy.
No. The reason why.
My friend, are you serious?
What's your question again?
Are you seriously telling me that you cannot answer my question without an analogy? Is that what you're saying? My question is, when God manifests himself as the Holy Spirit, is the Holy Spirit God?
Yeah.
It's a very simple question. Why do you need an analogy?
It's either yes or no. It's very God. It's God. I don't know. I'm trying to know why you're coming with that.
Are you saying is that a yes or a no?
It's yes. When, okay.
So why complicate it then?
Yeah.
But because I don't know where you're coming.
You don't need to know where I'm coming from.
It's a straight answer. The question it was.
It's not
okay.
True.
Yeah. Now the question here is, you see, if you believe that the Holy Spirit is God, yes? Why does the Holy Spirit need permission to speak, according to the Bible?
Okay, now I see you. Okay, that's why you were asking all these questions.
No, that's why I asked this one question.
I'll tell you why.
Go on, tell me why. So God needs permission to speak.
No, because
but you just said he's God. Okay, go on. So. You have the permission.
Yeah.
Carry on, go on.
Because from the beginning, my analogy of God. If you understand, so you're asking if why needs permission or
why does the Holy Spirit require permission from God to speak? If he himself is God, he doesn't need anyone's permission.
It's required permission to speak. Why does he say that?
It's in Matthew.
See, he's not aware of the verse. That's what it says. It shows.
You're not aware of it?
Probably.
Oh, sorry, it's in John 16.
What did he say?
John 16, where he says he will not speak anything of his own, but only what he hears, he will speak. I'm just paraphrasing. Yeah. Let me find the exact
words. The Comforter when he comes.
Yeah. Is in John 16, yeah?
Yeah, 16.
And also in John 14.
14 as well.
Yeah, because...
Is that?
Read the verse. I don't remember what...
He's finding it, brother. What? Brother, have you considered if you may well be wrong? Never.
And you do believe you are wrong?
What? No, no, if somebody pointed out some mistakes to me, yes, I may well consider that I may well be wrong. Do you get it? If you found contradictions or mistakes...
For me, the contradiction is dependent on the person. You can find contradiction in...
Okay, here it is.
He's found it.
You can
John
find a contradiction
16,
me is not a contradiction.
John 16, 13, it says, but when he, the Spirit of Truth, comes, he will guide you into all truth. He will not speak on his own. He will speak only what he hears.
Because if spirit is just...
I won't finish it.
I'm going to finish then.
Calm down. Why are you getting agitated? Okay. It's your Bible, by the way. I'm reading.
Is that you finish and you...
No, I didn't finish it. Okay. It says here, he will not speak on his own. He will speak only what he hears. And he will tell you what is yet to come. So here, the spirit will not speak of its own. He will only speak what he hears.
I mean, what is commanded, okay? That's what it means.
When does God speak on his own, or does he speak what he hears from someone else?
The way I understand this is it's just the spirit who is speaking. Is God speaking through the spirit? So I tell you why.
We said the spirit is God already.
The reason why it specifies that, the way I understand,
is not speaking on his own.
Exactly. The reason why it's specifying that is because he wants to say it's not two different entities.
Well, he does say he'll speak what he hears.
Yeah.
Hears from whom?
Just what the doctor is.
I'm telling you why. You ask me a question.
Yeah, based on the Bible. I'm
exactly.
Saying.
So he say, for me, the way I understand that is that it's
not too much.
Being speaking of.
According to this, it
is the same.
It doesn't say same. It says he will not speak of his own. He will speak what he hears. So the question to you is, if it was the same entity, is he hearing himself? Or is he hearing someone else? Another entity?
Because just an expression of the same.
Oh, jazakallah khair.
Are you
married? Not yet.
I wish.
Inshallah. Jazakallah
khair.
This is called baklava.
Try it. Arab.
Yeah.
Try it.
Nice taste, brother.
Sorry, you didn't get your pie. You got baklava instead. Is that okay, Naveed? Okay. So, the question...
The way I understand that, it's just trying to say that.
Sorry, he didn't take a baklava?
No.
Okay. He's just saying that it's the same being speaking. That's why I say he's not speaking.
No, he's saying he'll not speak on his own.
Yeah.
He will speak
because
what
because
he
was
hears.
If he was speaking on his own, he would be speaking here. Know what I mean?
Okay, whom does he hear? He says he will speak whom he hears. Whom does he hear?
Wait.
The question is,
who's talking to him?
Does the spirit listen to in order to speak? Whom does he hear? Which God? I thought you said he was God.
Let me explain.
Okay, go on.
The way I understand, for me it's simple, but I don't know why. Let's say I'm speaking, right? I'm speaking from my own, right? Let's say it's not two persons speaking here, another speaking here. So when the spirit speaks, it's like God is speaking. Now, I think it's in which part?
You speak on your own.
Okay, I think
that's fine.
Exodus.
But if you don't speak on your own,
let me give you the example. I think it is in the book of Judges.
Judges?
Oh yeah, you
open the book of Judges.
You open Judges.
Which verse?
In the beginning.
Chapter 1. Okay.
You got the Bible? Yeah. Open the book of Judges. Thank you.
Judges 1:1.
Why are you leaning back, Lias? Why are you leaning towards the tree?
I know something's attracting me.
While he's speaking, I'll have one more, just like a lot.
Why are you not eating? Why are you dying?
Why are you keeping him next to you?
I'm not keeping him. You can leave as long as you give me one more.
My English is not good.
You have French accent.
The Lord come up.
Accent français.
What is this? Gelag?
Let me read quickly. Yeah. And an angel of the Lord came up from Gilead of Gilead to Bochim, and said, I made you to go up out of Egypt, and I brought you unto the land which I swore unto your father, and I said, I will never break my covenant with you. So here, the angel of the Lord is speaking, and it's like God is speaking. God is speaking. Because if you read,
it's a messenger.
We got two different entities. One is God, and the other is not God. So that's not an example.
My question is about God. No. Your question.
There's only one God.
Okay, but here is saying an angel of the Lord. The angel of the Lord is speaking as if God is speaking, because I made you to go out of Egypt. I brought you onto the land which I swore unto your father. So if the angel,
he's mixing two things.
I'm not mixing. God is the one who brought the Israelites out of Egypt, and he's saying here, an angel of the Lord came from
to give him the message
and said, I made you. He didn't say God made you.
Over there is already clear. The angel is not God. Do you understand? The angel over there. We know the angel is not God. We both agree that the angel is not God. Is an angel God? Wait.
Do you worship angel?
Is an angel God?
How do you know that it's not God who's manifesting himself?
No. Oh, I see. So now you're saying that God doesn't only manifest as the Trinity, but he also manifests as angels, which are thousands of angels out there.
The angel of the Lord. And I think it's the same angel of the Lord. Who spoke to Moses?
This angel is acting like an ambassador. When an ambassador speaks on behalf of the king, yes, he's representing the king, but he's not the king. But you see, wait. In the example that I gave you, the Holy Spirit is the king.
Judges chapter 1.
You know what? He's not saying God say. He said, I brought you.
Just like an ambassador.
The ambassador represents
the king, and he reads his letter.
The ambassador would never say, I.
If he reads the letter of the king, he does.
Yes, he will.
Who says he reads the letter?
So is he God,
I didn't say
then?
I'm giving an example.
Who say? Read yourself.
Look, I know what you're trying to say, but the question arises, is the angel God?
Okay, the question arises, is it God manifesting himself? Sure.
Where does it say God manifests as angel? You're the one making the claim.
No. Because I'm just telling you, the angel of the Lord didn't say, God told me. He said, I brought you out of Egypt.
What are you trying to say? You're trying to tell me the angel
I'm
is God?
I'm trying to explain to you the passage that you read. The spirit doesn't speak on its own. That's why I'm trying to explain to you.
Okay, so the angel, that's fine. The angel here is listening to whom?
To God. Is just as the same, you know, the angel speaking is that God is speaking. So it's not two different.
But where did he get that message from? Where did that angel get that message?
It's just God speaking.
Whatever.
If you go, I'll show you another passage. I think it's in Exodus when he's speaking to Moses.
My friend,
the question is. I'll give you two examples.
The question is, what is the source of that speech of his?
It's just God speaking.
No. Where did he get that source from? Is it from God?
It's God speaking.
It's the angel speaking here, not the God speaking. Who's speaking here?
But he said, I brought you.
So make up your mind. Who's speaking, God or angel?
God is manifesting himself here.
So God manifests as angel. Where did he say that then? Where does it say God manifests?
You have two things.
Same words.
Whether it is God or is the angel. But he says...
You're not the same.
No, let me finish. But he said, I brought you out of Egypt. I brought you out of Egypt...
Hey, is your name Raphael?
Yeah.
Raphael. You tell me you're here. And I say, Raphael says, I'm here. Am I Raphael?
Come to the door, brother.
Sorry, can you answer that? Am I Raphael when I say...
from the Bible.
But that's what's happening there. The angel is saying, I...
No, you see, instead of you answering my question, you're going to another verse, which has got nothing to do with God. God and God. It's got to do with God and angel. Two different entities.
You're on three.
He's reading the message of God. The angel is...
What is it that's reading?
That's what he's doing. He's living the message.
He doesn't say manifest either. You're saying he manifests.
Yeah. Moses.
It looks like you can have your way, but we can't. Why does it say he manifests himself as God?
Since the beginning, it's two opinions. It's my opinion and your opinion.
No, it should be your opinion
based on
backed
the Bible.
Backed up with the Bible.
Exactly, but
so far,
the angel of the Lord say, "I brought you out of Egypt."
The angel of the Lord. Yeah, that you're right.
He said, "He didn't say God brought you out of Egypt."
On behalf of God, he's talking.
But why is he saying "I brought"? I give it
on behalf of God.
This is the way you speak, Raphael. This is the way you speak.
On behalf of God, as a messenger, like all the prophets, they don't speak from their own desire.
You know, that's an interpretation. Okay.
What do you mean? Actually, you're saying that he manifested as an angel. That's an interpretation. You're saying God manifested as an angel. Isn't that what you're claiming?
Why are you saying that?
Regardless of what he's saying, where does it say that God manifested as an angel?
You are on the path.
Unless you believe in more than the Trinity now.
No, I'm just telling you that this angel of the Lord didn't say God.
Because he's reading the message of God. When the solicitor comes out of the court to read the letter. No, it's not.
Just like you're asking him.
A way of reading.
You're asking him, where does it say that he's reading the message? I'm asking you, where does it say God manifested as an angel?
Yeah.
It says an angel of God.
Okay, so that's the point why we are discussing.
Okay, anyway,
because we have two opinions. You say he's reading. He's not saying he's reading.
Let's go back to John 16.
No, I'll give you this example.
Because I want to know who is the Holy Spirit listening to. Whom is he hearing in order to speak?
Okay, I'll give you another example. Okay.
So when Jesus says, "Is it not stated in the law that you are God's?" When he says "you," is that Jesus talking?
We don't trust it.
It's not Jesus talking.
Zom.
He's quoting.
Okay. Let me read.
You're going all over just to answer a simple question.
No. I will give it another example.
No, but it's got nothing to do with God and God. You need to bring a likeness of where God is listening to another being who is also God, who taking orders.
Taking permission.
You know, we have the text, and I see a different way. You see a different. I just tell
no, you.
You haven't even answered. I'm giving
you're
going
to a
second example, but because you're asking a lot of questions.
Okay, let
me answer this, and probably we're
going to. Okay, hopefully we'll get an answer. Yeah. To John 16:13.
The question is,
whom was he listening to?
And the angel of the Lord. Okay, look at this. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed. And Moses said, "I will not turn aside and see this great sign." And when the Lord saw that he turned aside, so first of all, the angel of the Lord appeared, and when the Lord so that he turned aside, God called unto him out of the midst of the bush, and he said, "Moses." So the angel of the Lord appeared, and God speak. So
God is speaking from where?
Is it from inside of the bush? That's what I was saying.
In there it says,
That's fine. What is the point you made?
Okay, so I gave you two examples.
Yes. Neither of them are right for life.
He's saying the angel of God is God.
No, I'm saying that
that's
the angel
his
of
point.
God
yeah.
is manifesting.
Is an expression. So God is expressing himself.
Where does he say that?
Yeah.
You are making these claims, but it doesn't back it up. Then.
See, I can say the angel set fire to the bush. I can say the angel came down to set fire to the bush.
Why is it said that the angel put fire in the bush?
That's the same way as you saying.
Exactly.
See?
So you know what? No.
You're saying the Holy Spirit is just
I got it. What? My opinion and your opinion. It's like two different opinions.
You know what? In order for you to answer, who was the Holy Spirit listening to? The question is, if the Holy Spirit is fully God, why does he need permission to speak only what he hears from God? If he himself is God, why does he need permission
to
speak?
Bible.
Why does he need permission to speak?
Because he says he will not speak of his own. Can God speak of his own?
Okay, I gave
because
you,
I believe
I,
he can.
I gave you the example.
Forget the examples. Without the examples.
No. This example explain answer.
It does
question.
Not.
No.
Okay. Because in the example,
that's your opinion.
Sorry.
In the example you gave,
yeah.
We are talking about not only God. We are talking about God and an angel.
Is that so? I'm telling you.
Unless you're telling me the Holy Spirit is an angel, then you would be agreeing with the Muslims.
Angel means messenger.
But is the Holy Spirit an angel?
You ask me too many questions. It's like
you're not answering. You're not answering clearly.
No, but the point
if I ask you complicated questions, I can understand.
Right.
But in order,
you ask me
this is something
you
already established.
Questions. and I answer, and you say
you went to judges, you went to Exodus to prove a point, right? That we can interpret both in different ways. But this one you cannot interpret in any other way.
You know what?
Because you said the Spirit is God.
You already agreed that the Holy Spirit is God.
That's what you agreed that.
You already agreed that the Holy Spirit is God.
So there's no other interpretation.
If the Holy Spirit is God, why does it need permission to speak?
Why does he need permission
to speak? Yes, because it says he will not speak of his own.
No,
does God speak of his own?
That okay.
Yes, he does. But according to this verse, he will not speak of his own. He will speak what he hears.
What was my explanation of that?
Your explanation is going to this verse.
Yes.
No,
which is basically
open to interpretation.
You ask a question, allow me to answer.
No, but you talked.
No, but you said, what is your explanation? Let me answer that.
Okay.
Okay? You gave an example about two entities between God and an angel in both cases. Yes? But my example, the one that I gave, is basically not the same. We are talking about the two entities that is mentioned in John 16:13. One is the Holy Spirit and the other is God Almighty. If God Almighty is telling the Holy Spirit what to speak, when to speak, if God Almighty is telling Jesus, in another verse, I can show you the verse, what to speak and when to speak.
Okay.
You see, here we are. Wait. I haven't finished the question. You need to listen to the question.
I listen, and I think you are repeating. That's why I will give
you
an
answer. No, you're not answering it. You're not addressing
it. The question I asked you is that does God need permission to? Okay, I'll make it very simple. Does God need permission to speak?
Okay. My answer is this verse you are interpreting wrong. That's my answer.
Forget about verse interpretation. I'm asking you
a particular
question.
Verse.
No, I'm forget the verse.
From your understanding.
Based on your understanding of what you believe in the Bible and your understanding of Christianity, yes, does God need permission to speak?
Does God need permission to speak?
Yes.
God doesn't need.
You know, I ask a Muslim this question.
No hesitation. No.
He will answer it without thinking so long.
God doesn't need permission to speak.
Yeah. Okay. Does the Holy Spirit need permission to speak?
Does the Holy Spirit need permission to speak?
Yes.
Does the Holy Spirit need permission to speak? The verse you are referring to is a wrong interpretation.
Forget the verse, just in general.
Based on your understanding of the Bible again,
there is no Bible.
Does the Holy Spirit need permission to speak?
Because the Holy Spirit is the Holy Spirit of God. So when He's speaking, it's God who's speaking.
Is that a yes or a no? Does the Holy Spirit need permission to speak?
Permission from who?
Anyone.
Regardless of anyone.
Does the Holy Spirit need permission?
You see, he didn't ask the same question about God.
Hesitation, yeah.
No, because
when I asked you about God, does God need permission to speak? You didn't say permission from what?
God. You know,
it's not a trick question, bro.
Does God need permission to speak? You did not ask the question from whom. But with the Holy Spirit, you ask this question. Why? Unless you see them as different. Unless you see them as different entities.
You know, it's very fast. I'm trying to.
Okay, no problem. Slow down.
Okay. Does the Holy Spirit need permission to speak?
The Holy Spirit is speaking on behalf of God.
That wasn't my question.
So he's.
My question is very simple. Does the Holy Spirit need permission to speak?
He doesn't need permission to speak.
Okay, so basically no. Okay, so over here when he says he will not speak of his own, what do you understand by that?
Okay.
Just that bit.
Okay, he doesn't speak on his own.
No, he says he. Yeah, sorry. Let me read the exact word here, so I do not.
I got another one.
It says here.
It's by himself, he says. King James.
No, he doesn't believe in the King James.
You don't believe in King James.
So you can put that back.
Yeah.
Okay,
King
so. Okay, here he says.
I don't blame him.
Yeah, actually, I was right. It says here he will not speak on his own.
Yeah.
He will speak only what he hears.
What he hears. Exactly.
So what do you understand by that?
I told you, and I repeat again. It's just saying that when the Holy Spirit is going to be speaking, it's not a different entity.
That's what he says.
That's how I understand this verse.
He says he will not speak of his own.
You
understand?
Yeah. He cannot speak by himself.
Because if he was speaking on his own, what would it mean? It would mean that it's a different entity speaking.
No, it would mean he's independent.
Okay.
Do you agree?
That's why I gave you these two verses.
Do you agree? If you speak on your own, you're independent. But if you need to, get permission in order to speak, then you're not independent to speak.
Exactly.
So do you believe the Holy Spirit is not independent to speak?
You are free than the Holy Spirit.
Brother, one second. Do you believe that the Holy Spirit is not independent to speak? Because God to me is a sovereign God. He is basically above everything. He does not need permission to speak or do anything.
The Holy Spirit,
he is the law himself.
Doesn't need permission to speak.
Sorry, say again?
The Holy Spirit doesn't need permission.
So why does he say he will not speak of his own? He will only speak.
I'm telling you what it means. Because if he was speaking on his own, he would be a different entity. That's what I'm trying to explain to you.
But don't you believe he's a different entity?
Huh?
You don't believe the Holy Spirit is a different entity?
It would be a different... Okay, talk being, it would be a different being. So, about
even different being, that makes it even worse. Because if he's a different being, then he's another God.
He's... You catch my English. Is it my English?
Your English is pretty good,
you,
I would say.
Okay, I'm telling you.
Better than some of the... Yeah. I've listened
je
to over here.
Le latin pas, s'il vous plaît.
Stop.
See,
I'm alone again.
No, you only have problem with English when the question is difficult.
I'm telling you, this verse, particular verse, means that if the Holy Spirit is speaking, he's not a different entity speaking. He's not a different being speaking. He's God speaking. That's all that it means.
That's not what it says here.
Okay, that's your interpretation then.
What do you mean, my interpretation? Yours? You see, when you hear someone, does it mean you hear yourself? When I say that, you are going to repeat what you hear from your father. Are you your father?
Because
at that point,
it's the way the Bible is written. You need to understand.
No,
how
I'm
the
using
Bible
the same language that is used in the Bible. If I say you, what's your name again? Raphael. If I say Raphael, it doesn't speak of his own. He speaks what he hears from his dad.
Huh?
Does that mean you are your dad? No.
We're talking about spiritual. We're not talking about.
In order for you, look. In order for you to give it.
We're talking about spirit. I just tell you.
Isn't those two examples you gave?
I explain you what this verse means.
You
don't want to accept my explanation. Can you go to a different step, a different point?
Hold on. Your explanation is trying to imply that here the Holy Spirit is God, but he doesn't speak on his own. It doesn't make sense, does it?
No. I'm telling you that this verse means the Spirit is speaking. You should not assume that it's a different being speaking. It's still God speaking. That's what this verse means. That's
so. So why does he say he doesn't speak of his own?
Because that's how it is written. And sometimes, even if you read it,
are you saying these people here wrote wrong English and you know better now?
No, because
it looks like you're trying.
You have different translations. So it's not understand what you want to say.
Are you saying these people here who wrote it in English, when they say he does not speak of his own? What do you understand just by that bit?
I'll tell you how I understand the Bible first. You're going to understand. The way I understand the Bible is you need to understand the intent of the
writer.
Verse. Exactly. What he's saying. The intent. You need to find the intent.
So you know the intent
of
John.
If you go by, I'm not a literate. I'm not very good in literature, or you guys are probably I don't know what your specialty.
If you go
by reading word by word, sometimes you miss the intent of what is written.
Hold on, you can never know the intent of the author until you read the whole context.
But you need to read everything, and sometimes in what he's saying, there's an intent, what you want to say.
I'll read it again if you don't agree,
let's move to another
No, wait. Let's read it once. Let's read for the last time, and then you tell me if I'm still wrong.
Let's move to another. We talk about it a lot.
Mouth is getting dry. That's fine. Let's hear it for the last time.
It's a
and then
bottle,
we,
brother. He has
and
a
he says here,
bottle is shut. It's shut, no?
No, if it's shut, I will drink.
Is it shut? Is it shut?
I don't know where it's got. This one? Oh, where's the other one gone?
Yeah. Okay, it doesn't matter.
It's been opened.
Ashim. You Ashim?
Yes.
Ashim? I answer this point. Let's move to another.
That's fine. Can I read it for the last time and then move on? Okay? It says here, but when he, the Spirit of Truth, comes, he will guide you into all the truth. He will not speak on his own. He will speak only what he hears. And he will tell you what is yet to come.
Okay.
So you see here, we say he.
Okay.
So it is not another speaking here. It is he, the Holy Spirit. He will not speak on his own. When he says he will not speak on his own, you're saying it is him speaking. You're completely contradicting what the Bible says.
You are just putting things in my mouth. I'm just telling you, and I say for the last time that.
Fine, say it for the last time. This verse means that the Spirit is speaking is not an independent entity speaking.
That's what we need, and I think we can move like that, and we never finish. Okay.
Guess what? We got an Englishman here. Can we ask an Englishman if he understands English?
No, I do understand English, amazingly.
Let's agree to disagree on that point.
No, that's fine. Let's agree to disagree, but I still want to know for the sake of clarification, because he can give someone here who speaks English better than me.
He can speak English better, but does he understand the intent?
When did you arrive? Last week?
I'm sure he knows. He knows the Bible quite well. So I'm sure you know the background of this verse.
Probably many people know the Bible.
Okay, the verse in John 16:13, when it talks about the Holy Spirit speaking not of his own, but speaks only what he hears. Do you believe this is, when he says he will not speak on his own, he will speak only what he hears? Yes? Do you believe that this is the Holy Spirit speaking, or is it someone other than the Holy Spirit? God the Father? I don't know, whom am I trying to say here? You said this is God speaking. Not the Holy Spirit.
I just told you that this verse, the way I understand it, means that he's speaking, but he's not an independent being. He's not God speaking. So that's what this whole verse means. And I told you that you need to understand it, the intent of what is written. But if you go the way you do, you don't catch the intent. So the intent, the way I understand the intent here, is that it's just saying the Spirit who is speaking is not a different entity speaking from God the way we know it. It's just God speaking.
So if it is only
that
God,
I understand it.
My friend, if it is only God speaking, then whom is he hearing? He will only speak what he hears. Whom is he hearing? God? The Holy Spirit is hearing God? Which God? The Father, the Son, or the Holy Spirit? No, because you...
I think you've got a good point. If you believe, as Christians do, that the Holy Spirit is fully God, it doesn't quite fit in with what John's Gospel is saying there, as the Holy Spirit saying that he will only say what he hears. Because the Holy Spirit, in your theology, shouldn't be hearing anything. He should be speaking
as God. He should be independent.
So I think the New Testament does not treat Trinity... does not teach Trinitarian. I know you have. But there are many examples where we can easily use to refute that very concept. Yeah. The idea came much, much later in the 3rd and 4th centuries of the Church, when the Catholic Church developed these doctrines.
I read about it. But it's not there in the first century. You don't need to tell me that I read about it.
So you agree with him that no one in the first century believed in
no
the Trinity?
No one taught the Trinity.
The way it is understood by, you say, the first century,
yeah,
the way it was understood and by many people.
Yeah, Paul didn't teach it, Jesus didn't teach it.
I agree with that. So it's not the point of the
discussion. No, but none of them believed in the Trinity like the way you do, unfortunately.